So good morning everyone. So this we are going to see binary subtraction using ones complement. So this is an important topic. We consider the two numbers as n1, n2. n1 is the first number, n2 is the second number. Second number we are going to subtract from first number. So there are two cases in this type, in this binary subtraction. Case one is if n1 greater than n2, what are the steps we have to follow? First one, n1 plus 1's complement of n2. And second step, add carry with LSB. LSB means least significant bit. Coming to case 2, when n1 is less than n2. Step number 1, n1 plus 1's complement of n2. Step number 2, no carry generated. So these two cases you have to remember to do the problems whenever comes under binary subtraction. So ones complement means, please remember, in case 1 carry will be generated. That carry we have to add with least significant bit. Least significant bit means rightmost digit, rightmost binary digits, whatever is there, either it is in the integer part or it is in the fraction part, we have to add that carry with LSB. So binary subtraction using 2's complement, same we consider here n1 minus n2. n1 means first number, n2 is the second number. And here we have two cases. So as we discussed by using 1's complement in the previous topic, similarly here also we have two cases. Case 1, if n1 is greater than n2, whereas case 2, if n1 is less than n2. So if n1 greater than n2, what are the steps we need to follow? First step, n1 plus 2's complement of n2. See, previously n1 plus 1's complement of n2 we already seen, that is in 1's complement method. Whereas in 2's complement method, n1 plus 2's complement of n2. Second step, ignore the carry. So remember here, there is a difference when we are seeing in the second step, clearly visible. Previously we add the carry, now we have to ignore the carry. Coming to case 2, n1 plus 2's complement of n2, the first step is same and second step is also same. No carry will be generated. So according to this, we are going to see some of the problems using 1's complement and 2's complement. See here the problem given. Binary number directly given in this, and we have to perform this binary subtraction using 2's complement method. So we'll see, n1 is 1011.10 and n2 is 1000.01. So what we need to do here, first we have to calculate the 1's complement of n2, then add 1 to get the 2's complement value of n2. So once if how to calculate the 1's complement value of any number, just replacing all the zeros by 1's and 1's by zeros, then what we will be getting, 0111.10 is my 1's complement value. Then add 1 with this number to get 2's complement value of n2. Then what is the 2's complement value of n2 here? 0111.11. Then this value I am going to add with the n1. If you add, you will be getting the carry, but we know in case 1, if carry generated, we have to ignore it. So in the right hand side, I have given the addition of these two numbers. What we will be getting? 0011.01, and carry actually generated, but that carry we ignored because this is a 2's complement method. So we'll see the next problem. Subtract 16 to the base 10 minus 83 to the base 10 using again 2's complement method. See, by seeing the 16 minus 83, which case this problem is belongs to? Case 2 type, because 83 is greater than 16. So this is case 2 type. So no carry will be generated. Remember that no carry will be generated, and the final answer will be the negative number. final answer will be a negative number. So n1, here the first number is considered as 16 and second number is 83. So we need to calculate the 2's complement value of 83. So as we all know, the given numbers are in decimal form. So first we need to convert it into binary form. Then from binary, as we discussed in the previous problem, in the same way we have to calculate the 2's complement value of n2. I hope you understand by seeing this how to calculate the 2's complement value of the second number. After getting the 2's complement value of the second number, add that number with the n1. See, one more thing we have seen here, that is adding the zeros with the first number. Why we are adding? Both numbers should be in equal length before going to add. So if any one number is not in the, if the length of the any one number is less than the another number, means what we need to do generally, we need to add the zeros to make the two numbers in equal length. So addition I have given in the right hand side. So after adding, what is the value we are getting? 0111101. So this is the final answer. For verification, what we need to do? We have to calculate the 2's complement value of the answer. So already PDF material shared. In that PDF material, please go through the problems. Even more problems solved in that material. Then you come to understand how to do this kind of problems, even in case 1 as well as in case 2 clearly. So see here in this slide, two more problems we are going to discuss based on 1's and 2's complement. Select 1's and 2's complement method to subtract the following. First values are 101.101 minus 111.1. So these two numbers, by seeing these two numbers, we understand that these are binary numbers. So initially no need to convert. Whereas in the second problem, both the numbers are octal numbers. So first what we need to do, we have to convert that octal number into binary number. So first my question is, problem number 1 is case 1 or case 2? And problem number 2 also, case 1 or case 2? That we have to find out. So by seeing the values, I understand that the problem number 1 is case 1 type. Why? Because the first number is greater than the second number. So see the second problem, it is case 2 type, because the second number is greater than the first number. So we'll see how to do this subtractions by using both 1's and 2's complement methods. First one, by using 1's complement method, how we are going to perform the binary subtraction, we'll see. 101.101 minus 111.1. This is what given in the question, right? So if you compare the length of the both numbers, whereas in the second number, the length is so lesser than the first number. See, integer part, fraction part, both are given. In the first number, integer part has 3 digits as well as fraction part also has 3 digits. So what we need to do here, we need to add zeros to make it into 3 digit number. So overall length of the number is 6 digit. Overall length of the number is 6. Now the second number's length is 6 after adding the zeros. And remember that you have to add the zeros in integer part only as a most significant bit, in the position of most significant bit. And zeros you have to add in the fraction part in the rightmost side, that is least significant bit side, right? Please kindly remember this. If you change the position of adding the zeros, then the value of the number will change. So that's why kindly remember this. In integer part means leftmost side, in fraction part means rightmost side. Now the same method we are going to follow. 1's complement of the second number I am going to calculate. So what is the ones complement value of the second number? 100.011. So we know very well how to calculate ones complement value. Just replacing all the zeros by ones and all the ones by zeros. Right. So now I have ones complement value of n2. What I need to do in the next step? I have to add that number with the n1. So I perform that addition in the right hand side. So 101.101, 100.011. So these two numbers, if I add, what I will be getting? 010.000 and one carry I am getting. Carry, what we need to do here, it is a case one type. So we have to add the carry, and it is, and we are using ones complement method. So we need to add the carry with least significant bit. Again, I'm telling you, we have to add the carry with least significant bit. Least significant bit means rightmost bit, whether it is an integer part or fraction part, whatever it may be, rightmost bit, whatever is there with that binary digit, you are going to add the carry. See here, after adding that carry, what we are getting here? 010.001. So that is the final answer which we are getting, right? Now we'll see the two's complement method. For the same problem, I'm going to apply two's complement method. See, same way, n2 actually is not in a sufficient length, so I need to add zeros to make it the equal length with n1. So I'm adding zeros. These steps we already discussed in the previous problem. Then again I'm going to calculate ones complement of n2. This value also we already calculated in the previous problem. What is the value we got? 100.011. Now here I have to calculate 2's complement value of n2, right? Because here, which method we are using? 2's complement method we are applying. So after adding 1 with the 1's complement of n2, what we are getting? 100.100. Add the 2's complement value with n1. Then what we will be getting? That addition I performed in the right hand side. Just see. 101.101, 100.100. If I add this two number, what we will be getting? 010.001. And we are having a carry also, but what carry we need to ignore it, because this is a 2's complement method. So in 2's complement method, kindly remember, we have to ignore the carry, but if it is 1's complement method, we have to add the carry. After adding, what we are getting? Final answer 010.001, or we can write it as 10.001. So I hope you understand this problem. So like this we have to do once whenever problem comes under 1's and 2's complement method. So we'll see case 2 type problem. One more problem we'll see, case based on. So in case 2, right, 15 minus 25 both are octal numbers given here. By seeing the values, I understand that this is a case 2 type. The reason is second number is greater than the first number. And moreover, whenever case 2 type problem comes, we know very well there is no carry for this case 2 type, right? So we'll see. Octal number is given here. So first, what we need to do? We need to convert that octal number into binary number. So after converting octal number into binary, of course we know very well how to convert octal to binary. So 15, equivalent binary value of 15 is 001101, and equivalent binary value of 25 is 010101. So now I have n1 n2 in binary form. Then as usual, which method we followed in the previous problem, the same method I am going to follow here also. First, what we have to calculate? 1's complement value of n2. What is the 1's complement value of n2? 1 0 1 0 1 0. After getting this value, add this value with the n1. So I perform that addition in the right hand side. After adding, what we are getting? 1 1 0 1 1 1. So this is what the final answer. Of course, if you want to represent in negative, you have to calculate 1's complement of the final answer. This already we discussed in the class. I hope you remember that. So why we need to calculate 1's complement value of the final answer means, in order to represent a number in negative form, in a negative value, right? So once if I calculate 1's complement value of the final answer, what I will be getting? 0 0 1 0 0. This is nothing but -1 0 0, nothing but what? -8, right? So we'll see, for the same problem, if I apply 2's complement, what will be my answer? See, by using 2's complement method, only difference is, after calculating 1's complement, we need to add 1 to get 2's complement. That's it. Remaining all other steps are same. So 15 minus 25, what is the binary equivalent of 15 0 0 1 0 1? What is the binary equivalent of 25 0 1 0 1 0 1? Now we have binary form of n1 and n2. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate the 1's complement value of n2, that is 1 0 1 0 1 0. After getting 1's complement value, add 1 to get the 2's complement value of n2, that is 1 0 1 0 1 1. Now add this 2's complement value of n2 with n1. See, I performed that addition in right hand side. After adding, what we will be getting? 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0. This is actually the 2's complement value of the negative number. If you want to represent this in negative form, what we need to do? We need to calculate the 2's complement value of the answer. Previously we did 1's complement value of the answer. Why? Because which method we used for the previous problem? 1's complement method. Now here we used actually 2's complement method. That's why we need to apply 2's complement for the final answer. Then what we will be getting? -001 0 0. See, just compare the answer of the previous problem. What is the answer we got? The same answer, -001 0 0. Here also we are getting the same answer, right? So any one of the answer, either you can represent in the 2's complement of the negative number, or directly you can represent a negative number. Both are correct. You can represent any one of this.